Greg Waldris, who couldn't be here today, had asked me to read your letter. But I was also going through some of Pat's things, and there were three things that hit me that I wanted to share with you, and I have 4 minutes. So, number one, when I met Pat, it was probably 1978, about the time I went to work at St. Calista's as the director for religious ed, and Pat had just become Catholic. So we connected, and Father Scott had been a great figure for many of us in the parish. And so through our friendship, we began to talk about the experience of our faith. And Pat shared a lot with me, and eventually she became a catechist. One day she shared with me a story, so this is kind of part two. When she was in fifth grade, there was something called release time for children in public school. Many of you may know about that. If you ever knew Sister Henrietta from the Sisters of St. Joseph, you knew about release time. And so Pat said she always wondered what these kids were doing, getting out of class for 45 minutes while she had to stay inside. So one day she snuck out, and she said they got to go in this crazy trailer. And when she walked in, it looked like a classroom. And there was a person there teaching, and there were desks, and there were posters, and she thought it was so cool, and they were learning about Jesus. That one day, that one catechist, at 11 years old, changed her way of life, because one day, when she was about 26, is when she became a Catholic. She never went to release time again. She may have gotten into trouble, I don't know. But that impressed her, so there was that seed that was planted. I also came across a letter, letter when she was looking for a job. She had been working in the parishes, always usually in conjunction with the church and with the school. So in 1989, she wrote a letter. It was her cover letter for her resume, and I saw a little piece in there, and I want to share that with you. As an adult convert to Catholicism in 1978, I have become very aware of the many blessings and the abundance of the grace of God. God has given me so much through the gift of music. Over the past years, music, education, and service to the people have been a major part of my life. But sharing the good news of Jesus Christ in sung prayer, in His Word, and in the Eucharist is the center of my life. And then we go to Mary, who cried the day she was on her way to the airport and got word that Pat had passed. She writes, first quoting from Leo Buscaglia, quote, "The fact that I can plant a seed and it becomes a flower, share a bit of knowledge and it becomes others, smile at someone and receive a smile in return, are to me continual spiritual exercise. Dear Pat, I have no idea how many seeds you have planted over the years. Twina, Kane, Ein, Cookie, on the phone nearly every night, usually about nothing. I've missed those calls the past 4 months. I dread getting home from Hawaii and never having those conversations again. One of our favorite songs, which Father Christopher quoted today also, "When love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing?" Pat, I know you're singing with the angels now, probably directing. Buscaglia also said, "Death is a challenge. It tells us not to waste time. It tells us to tell each other right now that we love each other." I love you, Pat. I know she loves all of you. Also, you're all invited to a luncheon afterwards.